Hi, this is Luke from NGN, and today we're going to talk about Coromon. Coromon is available on Steam as a demo right now, and is planned for release sometime this year. It is a monster capture, monster trainer type game, a la Digimon and Pokemon, and our first impressions for the game thus far are going to be broken down into four parts. First, the story. Is there a story? Is it funny? Is it sad? How does it stack up? We'll see. Then, the sound. How is the soundtrack? How are the sound effects? Are they any good? Do they hit the ear right? You'll see. Then the gameplay. How does the game feel to play? Is it that different? We'll find out. Then, speaking of difference, that's our X factor for Coromon. Digimon Hacker's Memory is a fantastic game and is available on a lot of platforms. Pokemon Sword and Shield is out. Is Coromon different enough from those games to warrant you picking it up and giving it a try? We'll see. You want to find out? Stick with us. Okay, our first impressions of Coromon are brought to you by MGN and Heartbeat Moments. What is MGN? That is the multi-gaming network. That's us. We're constantly providing you with gaming news, guides, reviews, and more from the MGN YouTube channel and from our blog, mgn.gg. So, check us out. What are Heartbeat Moments? I'm glad you asked. Heartbeat Moments are something that we've designed to bring our blogs to life. Say you're particularly interested in the story or sound design, you can click the time code next to that section in our blog and the video will automatically be pulled to your destination so that you can read and watch about your specific interest. How great is that? All right, moving on to Coromon. Coromon is first and foremost a monster capture, monster training game presented in the retro pixelated art style. It's full of charm, full of adorable creatures and moments, but don't let that trick you, don't let that fool you. There's plenty of depth there as well, both in the story and the gameplay. Fights are not the simple, I'm stronger than you, therefore I win. There's actual strategy, planning, and depth involved there. The art style, it's very reminiscent of something like Octopath Traveler. The pixelation is intentional and executed in such a way that you feel nostalgic for those sort of classic 90s monster capture games, but done well enough with enough finesse that it doesn't feel dated, much like Octopath does well. And that's a good thing. That's a good comparison in Coromon's favor. Okay, so is it different enough from the other games in the genre, both the retro versions and the current, to warrant you picking it up? Like I said in the intro, we'll find out. And our first impressions are gonna be broken down into four categories, like I mentioned in the intro: story, sound, gameplay, and X factor. The X factor for our impressions of games is usually different from game to game, to review to review. And today, we've decided to stick with the differences between Coromon and other games. Like I said, is it different enough? If it is that a good thing? Do the differences make it better? You wanna know? Stick with us, we'll get there. First, the story. I'm gonna give the story initially. Like I said, it's just in demo right now. It's coming out sometime this year, but what we've got thus far, I'm gonna give an 8 out of 10. The first thing I want to say about Coromon is that you will notice immediately it's funny, it's hilarious. Yes, the story is there and you're given enough early to interest you into playing the game through to find out what's happening, but what I love about Coromon thus far is that it weaves the humor in naturally with the storytelling. Neither feels forced to accelerate or move the other forward. The humor isn't over the top, it's not jammed down your throat at every possible opportunity. The developer or the writers have fit the humor in when it suits, and I have to say that it lands. It's cute, I like it. So let yourself relax, enjoy the story, and you'll get some light-hearted chuckles along the way. Story, 8 out of 10, well done. Sound is impressive. Sound, I've decided to give the sound thus far a 10 out of 10. The soundtrack is huge and it is perfect. It's relaxing and whimsical. It puts you into a state, really. A state to just sit back, relax, and let the charm of Coromon mellow you out. The game has little details as well, sound-wise, like birds chirping when a train disturbs them. So you can tell in those moments, the developer has obviously put a lot of thought into the little things. You can really tell in those moments they love their game, they love what they're doing, and they're proud of it, and they should be. If I have to give you a comparison, I would say that the music is executed well in a similar fashion to Stardew Valley. It's relaxed where it needs to be, like planting your vegetables in Stardew, or in Coromon's case, exploring and getting exposition, and it's exciting when you're in the mines, or in Coromon's case, battling your monsters. Everything has its place and it fits well. There's a lot of diversity and the diversity is placed well. The highest praise that I can give Coromon is that it does sound just as well as Stardew. Moving on to gameplay. Gameplay gets an 11 out of 10. How's that possible? Because I write the review and I can do whatever I want. Coromon is deep. It might seem like a simple monster capture, monster battle game on the surface, but where it stands out from other competitors like Nexomon, that's also on Steam, is how deep you can go. You're given the opportunity to make the game as easy or difficult as you want, and that's a really welcome feature that some of the other AAA games in the genre don't have or don't have anymore and are dying for. Like I said, the game's deep, all right? You can customize your character, there are stat growth curves, there's stat customization, there are puzzles, there are multiple regions, there are challenge modes in the difficulty. Look, everything that you want from the big guys in the genre, the developers have granted your wish in Coromon. So, for me, with those things fulfilled, I can't help but love what they've done with Coromon so far for giving the audience exactly what they want. They've watched what the audience wants in the genre, and then they've gone ahead and made that for you. Thank you very much. 11 out of 10, guys. Moving on to the last point, which is X Factor. Like I mentioned earlier, the X Factor is how different and is the difference good? I've already covered a lot about how Coromon is different from other games in the genre, especially against the big two, Pokemon, Digimon. But is it different enough to the point where if you've played the latest releases of those games already and are enjoying them or have enjoyed them, should you shift to spending your time on Coromon? The answer is a resounding yes. You're going to get more out of your experience playing Coromon. How can I say that? Because I have those other games and I play them regularly, but I'd rather be playing the full release of Coromon. I'm eagerly awaiting it, and I know that the Steam playtime for that game when it comes out is going to be a big number. Why? Well, like I mentioned, Coromon is extremely deep, and it'll provide you a genuine challenge depending on your chosen difficulty. But also, the developers and the publishers of the big two aren't flexible or very interactive with their audience. Sometimes it doesn't feel like they listen or that they want to listen. This is another thing that Coromon does better than them, and that makes the future of the game very exciting. So, if that sounds like something that you'd be interested in, give the demo for Coromon a try. Be sure to add the game to your Steam wishlist so you can pick it up when it drops. That's going to about cover it for our initial impressions of Coromon thus far. Make sure to keep up with the blog, keep up with the YouTube for more Coromon content. Thank you again for listening.